In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to improve your pass protection with the cut block mechanic in Madden NFL 20. What's up, guys? My name's Cody, and welcome to my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel centers around helping you get better in Madden NFL 20 and ultimately in Madden NFL 21. And if that's something that interests you, what I want to encourage you to do is watch the video all the way through. If it helps you, then be sure to join our Discord server. You can join in on the conversation at Discord. That's basically kind of the foundation of everything that I do is that server. And that's a way for me to be able to connect with you guys and also a way for you to get access to a free offensive and defensive guide that I'll be releasing on our Discord server once we pass 100 members on Discord. So that's the goal. Let's jump into the video here. So again, I'm showing you a simple mechanic that's going to help you roll out better or just even pick up pressure better in Madden NFL 20. I'm going to do it just from a simple blitzing set here. We're going to show it to you from the 2-4-5. And I'm just going to flip the spread just to kind of give you this very simple example. So at the snap of the ball, what I like to do is I like to look for ways that the defense can pressure me. So they may set something up like this right here. This is a very common look here out of the nickel 2-4-5. So you see here that the pressure, realistically, there's no hot blitzer coming here. Unless they did something like this, I don't have to worry about pressure from the right side. I know that about the formation. I know the primary pressure is going to come from the left side, from the nickel blitz. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my running back, and I'm going to place him on a block and release pattern. But the problem is, in Madden, if I just snap the ball here, you'll see he's going to go out if the line can pick him up. But what happens this year, because of the really good pass rushing skills of the line and different things like that, you actually want to have a little bit more of a set thing. And so how do you tell your running back who to block? Well, you do that through the ID the mic feature. So if you click the right stick in, you're going to see it's going to give you a pre-play adjustment menu. By holding right trigger, I can look at the X factors on the field. By holding left trigger, I can look at play art, right? And then I can also do several other things as well once if I'm not having two controllers, right? I can also hot rod in triangle, I can audible, but I can bring the pass protection up by hitting L1. What that's going to do is it's going to allow me a couple of options. I can slide to the left by flicking the right stick to the left. I can slide the line to the right by flicking the right stick to the right. I can double team someone by flicking it down. And you see here, with using that left joystick, I can pick which person on the line of scrimmage that I'm going to double team. So if they have a really good nose tackle, I might want to double team him. I can also max protect. What max protect is it simply blocks all of the eligible blockers. In this scenario, it's the halfback. But what I want to do is I want to basically tell the halfback who to block. Well, I do that through ID in the mic. Watch what happens. I'm going to ID the mic. You see it's going to bring up this icon. And basically anyone who is possibly going to be able to blitz, it's going to give me that option. I can ID a corner, I can ID a safety, whatever. So if this is that blitzer that could potentially come off of that left edge, so I'm going to ID him. And here you're going to see at the snap of the ball, the running back is going to sit and wait and make sure he gets picked up. One strategy that people have been utilizing in Madden NFL 20, especially for escape artist quarterbacks, what you might do, especially like, for example, I'm Patrick Mahomes, and I like to roll out to the right because he's right-handed. What I could do is I could double-team Ward here, which is going to tell my tackle and my guard to double-team them. I could then put my running back on a block, and I can ID the right-of-screen guy that I want him to cut, which in this scenario is the defensive end. You'll see at the snap of the ball, he's going to cut him. That allows me to roll out, and we all know how good throwing on the run is in Madden NFL 20. So that's a very simple technique that you can use to pick up pressure, but I want to show you why it's so important. It's so important to ID the mic in your pass protection, not just so that you can get cut blocks on really good guys. For example, they may have like an edge threat elite or whatever that you want to cut, because literally it's going to cut him every single time. But what if you just want to pick up some pressure, right? What if your opponent is sending this kind of pressure at you, the really, really good pressure from that left edge? Well, what I like to do is I like to take my running back, I like to motion him to the side of which I think the blitz is going to be. From ID that specific blitzer, whoever that blitz is, and then I'm going to either slide away from it, basically do a half slide, so that in theory you can pick up the right edge pressure and the left edge pressure, or you can just leave him as is. And you'll see here at the snap of the ball, he's going to pick him up. I can roll out with Mahomes, and I can score more points that way. So again, that's a little tip that you could use with that ID the mic feature. I think it's very critical to understand what that does. If you actually watch Patrick Mahomes, you see he's got in game, he would point to these people. You're basically telling your running back, I want you to make sure that this specific player is blocked. It's a really good feature, and not enough people are using it, especially from the shotgun spread, where pass protection is vital if you're going to be successful. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it was helpful. Hope it gave you something tangible that you can use to go get better in the game. And if it did, what I encourage you to do is to join our Discord server. And the reason I want you to join our Discord server is, number one, I want to give you a free offensive and defensive guide whenever we get to 100 followers on there. But the other reason I want you to join our Discord server is because I think it's going to help you, because it's not just me there, but it's all of our community there coming together around one common theme, and that is to be the